Hi, I'm Ronnie Cohen, CEO of ViVision. And ViVision is doing environmental perception for autonomous vehicles. It means that we're taking all the road data from the sensors around the car, the cameras, the LiDARs, and the radars, and we are generating a detailed, accurate, and reliable description of everything around the car, the cars, the pedestrians, the lanes, the traffic signs. And this is called the environmental model. We are an Israeli company, 30 employees, raised already $12 million, and already also engaged with leading OEMs and tier ones. Now, I don't think I have to tell you about the market. You know that autonomous is a huge market. However, lately, in the last 3 months, you may have heard some releases about delays and setbacks. It doesn't mean that it's not going to happen, but it means that the leading companies, the leading OEMs and tier ones in this market, realize that the challenge is bigger than expected. And now, more than ever, they are willing to focus their resources on their core competency, which is more on the driving, and get from companies like ViVision the tough, deep tech perception part. And perception is in the heart of the problem and the challenge of autonomous driving. It both relates to the quality and safety of the driving, but it also relates to the cost, because the first generation of solutions is doing processing separately on each sensor, separately on the camera, on the LiDAR, on the radar. Each one is trying to detect all these objects, the cars, the pedestrians, and none of them is reliable enough. So they're putting multiple sensors and trying to fuse these non-reliable detections into a reliable environmental model. Not just that it doesn't work well, also it causes them to put a lot of sensors and a lot of processing. The solution for that is to go for the next generation, that is raw data fusion. It means it's a basic, simple idea. Take all the raw data from all the sensors, all the pixels from the camera, all the measurements of the LiDAR and the radar into one place, into the ECU, and then try to make an optimal detection based on all the data. It's definitely the right way and acknowledged by the industry, but it's easier said than done. And that's exactly what we're doing. We have the technology to do a very efficient and optimal raw data fusion with a unique upsampling technology. Now, that's a complex block diagram just to tell you that, so we'll see it's in complex, but I will simplify it. It's basically two phases. On the left side, we're doing fusion, where we merge perfectly calibrated and synchronized the camera, LiDAR, and radar into one unified image. We call it the RGBD model, where for each pixel, we have both the color, the RGB, as well as the distance and the velocity. It's like an ultra-high-resolution 3D model, and that's the input for our sensors, for our detection algorithms, and this is why we can do better detections with less computation. Let's see how it looks like. This is a street measured on the bottom. You can see measured by a very expensive Velodyne LiDAR, and still it's very sparse. It's very difficult to detect the car and RV that you can see parked on the road. But after upsampling, it's much better. So that's the resolution added by our upsampling technology. And that's how it looks in real time. This is not a video. This is a ultra-high resolution 3D model that we generate in real time as the car is going by. And that will be the input for our detection. This is why we can do better detections. And if you will just see in a second, we're going to zoom in and turn it. You see it's a real full 3D model. So when we feed that model to the algorithms, we can do great detections. So we're detecting here in Tel Aviv in a dense urban environment, pedestrian, cars, free space, motorcycles. But our customers ask us about more advanced features. First of all, functional safety, the most important thing. So what happens if one of the sensors is failing? We show them that in our system, we automatically compensate from one sensor to the other. You can see here when the camera is blind from the sun getting out of the tunnel, free space is exactly in the right place because 3D is compensating. Shadows on the road, always a problem with camera-based solution. Not in our case. All the sensors compensate for that, and it's a non-issue. Small obstacles is another important one. It's easier to detect cars, pedestrians, but what about an unclassified small object? In this case, the system has detected, to our surprise, two peacocks walking on the street. Now look at the female on the side. It's very small, it's gray, it's very difficult to detect. We've seen it from a long distance. We know exactly where it is, what's the height, what's the velocity. And that's very important because we have never seen peacocks before. Another functional safety element embedded in our solution is that the fact that we are doing both DNN algorithms, deep neural network, AI, as you can see on the bottom, that are based on detection by classification and are based on training. You need to do a lot of test drives and they will detect what they were trained on. But I've been driving now for 30 years and I'm still surprised from things I see on the road on a weekly basis. So training will never cover everything. So on the top, we have another set of algorithms working in parallel, detecting everything without DNN. And it's our promise to our customers. We will detect everything. We will detect the unexpected, we'll detect the unclassified, and everything will be in the environmental model in the occupancy grid. And everything that you've seen here is done in real time with only one LiDAR, one camera, one radar on a single NVIDIA processor. So it's both high quality and very reliable, but also very efficient. This is why it's very attractive. And today we're already engaged with six leading OEMs and Tier 1s, several in the leading German ones and some others elsewhere in the world. And in order to support getting our product to the market, both productization as well as getting eventually into integration and supply agreement with these customers, we are raising now our next round, the A round of 20 million, which will bring us to these targets. And you're most welcome to approach me later if you are interested. Thank you.